The David Feldman radio program is made possible by listeners like you. You sad, pathetic humps.
Welcome to the broadcast. I'm David Feldman, davidfeldmanshow.com. As everybody who listens to this show knows, when I was doing the Hulu show with Triumph on the road, we needed guest hosts. So Frank Conniff filled in for me, a couple of other people filled in, and it was amazing. It was just, we got, the numbers went through the roof. Everybody said, you finally solved the problem of the David Feldman show. It's David Feldman. So please welcome our guest host, Keith from Keith and the Girl. You're going to be the permanent guest host of my show.
Thank you. And thank you for having no ego about it. Super Tuesday was this past, I think it was Tuesday?
Classic David.
Classic David. The reason Trump is doing so well in Arkansas is due to his constantly talking about how he wants to bang his own daughter. That's what they do down there.
You know what? That joke was so good because there was like no Jew after effect in it. I think, you know.
Yeah, it was innocent.
Yeah.
Oh,
yes,
Hillary's winning in Massachusetts. Yeah, okay. By a Carly four ear and a hair. You know what I mean?
I think I do.
Yeah.
But
that would be pronounced Carly Fiorina. But it would be...
Who's the host, David?
Carly Fiorina hair. But that's...
This is why your show does better with a co-host.
David? Yeah,
with
a guest host,
I mean,
host,
wow, with
better.
The interrupty.
We have to think about my voice.
I'm sorry.
You know what I mean?
Right. Carly Fiorina hair.
Thursday was the big debate.
Yes?
If Thursday's debate were an episode of The Flintstones, Brett Baer would be Brett Boulder of Rox News. I don't know any of these people.
Wilma!
Right. Nice. Nice.
Well, I think the writer, because I hired some of the best writers in show business for you. I think...
What do you think they meant?
I think they're saying that Brett Baer from Fox News looks like a Flintstones character.
Right, right.
So he would be Brett Boulder.
Flintstone. Dr. Ben Carson was going to show up, but he received a last-minute robocall from Ted Cruz telling him the debate was actually the Academy Awards and he wasn't nominated, and could these be more wordy? Hey, seriously, though, did you guys see the Oscars? Black America sent a message that Hollywood's going to remember for three or four days to come. Instead of like a long time.
Hashtag Black Lives Matter.
No, honestly, guys, the Oscars were the best in years, and you know the producers were going, hey, we should fail to nominate people of color more often. This is what I get. Okay.
No, it's not funny, but it's like a good
political
point.
Think. Yeah. Right, right, right. I hear Donald Trump's cock is up for an Oscar in the category of best short. I mean, is this guy overcompensating or what? Am I talking about? Oh, there's more Christ. Thanks to Donald Trump, the GOP has finally gone from the part of Lincoln.
Oh, the party of.
This says part. I don't...
A writer just got fired. That's cool.
A Secret Service agent protecting Trump...
This is a smart one.
Yeah,
it's not going to get a laugh, but it's a thinker.
Right, this one's for the college kids. Thanks to Donald Trump, the GOP has finally gone from the party of Lincoln to the party of Jefferson. Davis!
Philosophy class right there, 101. Pretty
Davis.
Good. Just think about it.
I like that delivery.
Thank you.
Davis. He was the president of the Confederacy, so it's...
The president of the Confederacy, so it's...
Yeah, not funny.
A Secret Service agent protecting Trump beat up a photographer for Time magazine. Nice to see my good friend Alec Baldwin finding work again. What? No, it's true.
He beats up paparazzi, now he's working for the Secret Service. That's the premise
of
the joke.
Okay. Right. Well, a lot of people these days are comparing him to Mussolini, and I think that's unfair. I know it's not nice to Mussolini. What are we talking about? It's the truth. I think it's unfair to call Trump a fascist. I see him more as a Nazi. That's what I see. That is so true.
Thank you.
Oh, David Duke is really taking the heat. Oh, my God. You reading this in the news, guys?
He's
taking the heat. The Motion Picture Academy of Arts and Sciences just revoked his membership. That means no more screeners. But the screeners are the whole fun part of it. How do these headphones work?
Wait, my writer gave me a joke.
Oh, okay.
Hang on for 1 second. Keith, reading these jokes, you sound like Andrew Dice Gay.
Oh, no!
Oh, homophobia!
Evil Gay, put it in my mouth! I suck on it, Evil Gay!
D&D. Jack and Jill.
I'm over here now.
Oh! Get it?
It's so much better with a guest host.
Well, we bring a new energy. Megyn Kelly's eyelashes are longer than Donald Trump's fingers tonight. I mean, this guy has fey fingers. Trump had this look on his face like he smells what he's saying.
A whole bunch of bullshit.
Oh, it's my birthday.
Is it really your birthday?
No.
Oh, okay.
No, it's the worst day of my life. I'm confused, though, guys. Seriously, folks. Everybody relax. I'm confused. When Mitt Romney calls Donald Trump a phony and a fraud, does that mean he's endorsing him?
Oh, it's like he's talking about himself. Like, is there a mirror in here? Something else?
There's only 10 more pages.
Okay, good.
Holy shit.
I think you're doing great.
How long is that phone battery?
This is good for the show.
There could have been a way for the GOP to stop Trump's votes from being counted, but Scalia went and died on us, the guy from the court.
Scalia.
It was Scalia, you call him. It must be difficult.
You call him Scalia?
Yeah. I never liked him. I don't respect
him. Because he's like a lizard.
When I don't respect people, I don't say their names right.
He's a snake oil salesman.
He's like a lizard. Okay.
It must be difficult for all these diehard Republicans being forced to disavow white supremacists with Scalia's corpse barely cold. It's probably something that makes sense.
Well, it's...
Yeah.
It's not funny.
No, I like it.
All right.
It's more like an encyclopedia thing.
This is actually passive-aggressive. Like, what I'm doing is I'm giving you really lousy jokes as the guest host.
Now I realize
it looks like I have no ego, but what I'm really trying to do is humiliate you.
Did you notice this? Now that enough time has passed, isn't it ironic that Antonin Scalia, the most homophobic judge on the Supreme Court, died biting a pillow? He put that dick in my mouth! Nice!
You know what is interesting most? Do you know the term pillow biter?
I am familiar with the term.
Okay, because I
lived the term.
I didn't know that that your generation doesn't know the term pillow biter.
Is that a thing about my generation?
Yes.
They do say that.
Millennials are more into the word faggot.
Ooh. Millennials.
Oh, I used to say that word all the time. Yeah.
I'm a millennial. I think she should leave Donald. Go ahead.
That's Donald's wife. Oh. Megyn McCain. Here's some thoughts.
Oh, that's it. That's it.
So, Megyn and Megyn McCain.
Nah. So, the best part was David explaining the jokes.
Tell the audience that we're going to take a quick break.
We're going to take a quick break.
And we're going to be back with Keith and the girl.
And we'll be right back with Keith and the girl. Welcome back to the David Feldman Show. I'm guest host Keith from Keith and the Girl. Hemd is here with me, of course, the girl.
I am.
Okay, and let's go around the table and say hello. Let's start with Jew number one.
Hey, I'm Gabriel Lax.
And Jew number two.
I am Andrew Goldstein.
And, of course, David Feldman is joining us as well.
Hello, I'm
David.
Jew number five.
Not my place to say.
Andrew looks mad because I believe he was promised to be Jew number one. So I don't know how you're going to work that out between you guys.
I think we could switch spots because I'm only half Jewish. I feel like I don't deserve the coveted Jew number one spot.
You don't count.
One of the things we do for our guest host here is, you know, both of you are very quick-witted.
He's pointing at me.
Both of you. You're very funny. But we like to provide a Jew for each guest so that they can be witty.
Appreciate it.
So Andrew over here is a full Jew.
Okay.
We feel you need a
full... Can I take that one? Yeah.
You can take the full Jew. And Chemda, no offense,
Jewish,
Keith, but Chemda is a little funnier
right.
than you. So she only needs half a Jew. So
right.
we gave her Gay Blacks, who's half a Jew.
Right.
I feel like I came in last in the draft.
So any jokes you need or anything. In fact, we can switch. Why don't we switch places so you get full access your Jew.
Thank you.
Plus, then the audience could feel like more intimate. You know, I feel like they could feel that he was in the wrong place just now.
I always like them
that
on hand.
Came across.
Yeah.
And just so you know, here is Andrew's circumcision papers.
Mm, thank you.
And his bar mitzvah
looks good.
Documents.
I'm going to need pictures from my Jew.
Full 100% Jew.
I can show you a bunch of pictures of me and my mom hanging out.
I'm going to need dick pics. Sorry.
Gabe might be half Jewish, but his name is full Jewish. Gabe, what is it? Gabe Wax.
Wax.
Wax. Jesus.
Wax.
I know his Black Panther brother, X-Lax, who...
I swear, it sounded like you called him Gay Blacks.
I like when David starts something and he's like, something's going to come, just wait. Yeah. Ah, fuck.
most of Brazil's job is editing down those pauses.
So, David, what's new?
Oh, I don't know. I was curious. I wanted to talk to you guys about podcasting and the current state of the industry. And there's a guy running for president who I really think has captured the imagination.
Crocodile Dundee.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's fantastic.
He's so good. Mm-hmm.
And I think this race in Australia is going to be very surprising.
Yeah. It's like, that's not a country, you know?
Mm-hmm.
That's a country.
Yeah.
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 It's a good platform to run on. Good talk, you guys.
Oh, okay. I didn't know this hosting was serious. All right.
No, you're hosting the show. It's better when I'm just a guest on my own show. Trust me.
You guys, think about this, right? I grew up Jewish.
Yeah.
You guys are committing to the Jew bit.
Sure.
Right? Okay.
A little bit.
Yeah. No, like in life, right?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. So I figured, like, me growing up Jewish, I went to yeshiva. That's, like, enough funny injected. And then I decided to be atheist because I said, you know, like these goys, they got some jokes too.
Yeah.
So I've been atheist for a while.
Okay.
And I'm not sure if it affected my jokes. Jew, would you have said what I just said funnier as a half Jew still living in your Jew state of mind?
Oh, good question. I don't think it would have been nearly as funny. I think that you nailed it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, interesting.
Right. See, as the writer, I have to compliment the performer at all times.
Oh, then I should talk to you more often.
You really
that was fun. Yeah. Thank you very much. So that's my Jew, Keith.
Do you get upset, David, when you write jokes for people?
Yes.
And that
yes, I do. Very upset. It's killing me inside. I'm just rotting.
Do they often blow it or not, say it the right way?
They tell it better. They get bigger laughs and people. It's kind of frustrating because I can write, like when I tweet, I'll write something and it's really, I think, clever.
Right.
You know, like I have this joke. My doctor, I tweeted this. My doctor says I need to eat more greens.
Ew.
And I tweeted that.
How do you tweet that?
How do you spell that?
What do you mean?
Is it a video?
I don't know.
Did you do like parentheses eats boogers?
Dude, hashtag phlegm.
B-B-B-P. And you know he kept going like... Okay, well, how does that sound? Okay, it's more... Would it start CH? Fucking 5 hours later, he sends it.
Yeah. He tweeted it and deleted it with five different spellings.
He's got to go to the doctor now.
It gets nothing. Gets
right,
nothing.
Sure.
Zero. No retweets. Nothing.
Wait, just
I
so
lose
you know,
followers.
Everyone in here does not understand that for like a split second because that was just golden. I don't know how I didn't retweet that. Just that kind of stuff passes by me, and this is why I can't go to the next step in my comedy career.
I heard Twitter was down for half a second. Maybe that was it.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. It was timing.
Yeah.
But the frustration is if I were to give a bon mot like that to a celebrity,
right,
it would get a million retweets, and people would think it's the greatest.
I'll tell you why. Because if you give a funny joke to someone who normally doesn't tell jokes, everyone's just surprised that they said half a joke. It's like giving jokes to people, your coworkers in a 9-to-5.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, oh, wow, you were funnier than, I don't know.
Yeah, I've been using that greens joke for, I mean, just all day today. Bus driver. Oh, they love it. They love it, but they don't expect it from me. I'm just a regular, you know, civilian walking around.
He's not even a Jew.
Yeah, they love it. They're like, are you half Jewish? And I'm like, no.
I just know how to make the sounds.
Yeah, I just don't, you know.
So what was your question?
What?
When you, that was it. You answered it. When you write for people, do they sometimes blow it? And are you devastated?
Andrew, you're a comedy writer. Gabe, you're a comedy writer.
Sure.
Which one's better?
Am I devastated? Let's talk about me. Am I devastated?
I think every comedy writer thinks they can do better than the person they're writing it for.
Really?
At least when I write.
Why are you looking at me?
At least when I write for a host. For the most part, I'm always like, oh, God.
Can't you tell where the comma was, you
exactly.
fucking idiot?
Don't you know how an ellipsis works,
right.
Nick Lachey?
Don't you have comedy crushes? Don't you, like, fall in love with
the guy you're writing for, or the girl
you're writing for?
When they nail it, they nail it, and it's, like, the best feeling in the world.
Wait, I want to go back 20 seconds. You wrote jokes for Nick Lachey?
Yeah, I wrote for Nick Lachey.
We're all in love with you.
He hosted a morning show on VH1.
Whoa, what is that process like?
Is that from 98 Degrees?
Yeah.
David, name one song, David. So it does hit me 98 degrees.
98 degrees is way too hot for Jews.
Something to my heart.
Yeah. All
right. Something. My kids used
something.
My quote. My daughter was in love with Nick Lachey.
Something like "I'm still in love with you. Let's get back together."
It played in the car all the time.
Sure.
When's the last time you talked?
It's the hardest thing I'll ever have to do.
To Nick Lachey?
That was another song. Yeah.
I thought you were talking about rating for comedians.
If you would have stayed Jewish, you would have gotten that. But when you lost all ability to
finish sentences.
Let's go around the room. David, when's the last time you talked to your daughter?
Wow.
We'll hit up everybody.
Does testifying in court count?
Yeah, that counts. That counts. Gabe, last time you talked to David's daughter.
You're talking about that daughter. Hold on. Just making sure.
All right. Well, I got a New York Times in front of me, I see. What do we think about the Times, David?
I think it's the Talmud.
Okay.
Wow. It should be interpreted however you want, depending on who's your teacher. No? Is that only me that learned that in yeshiva?
I think that you need a good book to work off, and there are flaws in every good book.
Right.
But I think the New York Times is the good book, and if everybody read it in this country, we would not be where we are right now.
David, you are easily half an hour late to your own show.
Yes.
Do you not respect people, or is it an honest-to-God disease? Is it like depression and I should feel bad for you?
You want me to answer honestly?
Yeah, please.
Okay.
Lie to me.
It's a combination of not wanting to spend money on a personal assistant.
Okay.
I need a personal assistant. So I
to what? Slap you out of bed?
Yes.
Okay.
And so I don't have a personal assistant. So I do all my stuff by myself. And I'm also...
Did you forget that you had to do a show today?
No. I'm an alcoholic.
Okay.
I haven't had it. This is... So I'm softening you up by telling you that. And so I have very few thrills in life. And one of the thrills in life...
is rushing to be on time.
Rushing to be on time. I mean that. I can't do anything about it. So it's like if I nail it, I feel like I've cheated the universe if I get someplace on time, given all the bad karma.
In spite of yourself.
Yes.
Right.
And today was not good. And finally, I have zero respect for other people. I'm a malignant narcissist, and I just don't care about other... No,
it's why Jews are so attracted to you.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
I like apologizing a lot.
They make me feel better going, it's okay.
Well, no, it's a preemptive strike. It's great to walk into a room and just go, I'm sorry.
Right.
Before you've said anything, just to start off, I'm sorry.
How could anyone be mad at you?
Yeah, I'm sorry. So,
well, he's sorry, you guys.
Yeah,
that's why I automatically have an I'm sorry for being late.
Kenda has a delayed problem. But if we're going
to... Maybe she's pregnant.
Just forever.
Right?
Yeah, I do.
But sometimes Kendall will say, I'll tell him we'll be there to wherever we're going in 5 minutes. I'm like, we won't, though. We won't be there for another, I don't know, 20 minutes, half hour.
What it's is
like,
time? But just Let's tell think
him,
about that.
Just tell him 5 minutes, and it shows him we're, what, rude? We respect we're late, but we're going to lie to you again.
What? David, this is your fault. First of all, I was here 15 minutes before Keith. Hey, okay? That's one. I was very proud of myself. I was amazed. I was floored. I was like, what do I do now? I'm walking up and down the street. I swear to God, because I was like so early, and I knew I don't like when people come early to my place, so I don't like doing it to them. So I'm walking up and down the street, and I went into a bodega. I went into like a cafe, but like nothing struck me, right? And then I'm thinking, I've been on my phone, I've been walking up and down this block. When I see Keith, I'm going to like slap him and then hold his hand and then like let go. And then we're going to get arrested for a drug deal because I look so suspect right now. And that happened to our friend of ours. Yeah. Like he's just...
But can I give you a compliment?
Oh, no, I'm talking.
The scenario you describe is you would not be arrested. You're so beautiful. You would not be arrested for dealing drugs. You would be arrested for being a hooer.
Oh,
that's how beautiful you are.
Is that what happens to beautiful people? Oh my God, I need to work on being arrested more often.
That's actually how I met my wife. I
said, hey, how horrible was that?
No.
What I just said.
How horrible?
No, when I
perfect
met,
amount.
When I met my wife, I said, you are so fucking beautiful. You could be a whore.
Yeah.
And
actually,
long story short, there's a ring on my finger.
Last time I got a whore, I walked up and down the block and just went, just slap him. You know, it's. I mean, that's like the sexiest thing you can do.
Well, so. I proposed to my third wife. I said, you know, instead of giving you $50 every time I see you, why don't I just give you half of everything I own?
And she's like, wife. But that's like half of whatever the other two women didn't get. This math is not working up for a Jew perspective.
Well, I gave her half of everything I own, which was actually $25.
How many times have you been married?
Seven times.
Three times?
Seven times.
Was it three times?
You know what? I lie about everything in my personal life.
Mm. Okay. How many times do you guys know? Was it just once or more?
I'm going to go six.
Six times?
All right.
Let's just say I'm going through a divorce.
Right, but just one.
Well,
he's only going through one currently.
One at a time.
Yeah.
And I'm instead of a divorce attorney, I'm looking for a hitman to fucking kill me. I just want a hitman to take me out of my pain.
Is that why we're here?
We had a guest on Keith and the Girl, and their parents were getting, or their dad was getting into his fourth marriage or fourth divorce.
Oh, yeah.
And it makes me wonder when you get, should there be a limit? You know, when you're at the fourth one and you're like, but this time
I really love cocktail hour.
Right. I know forever this one. Like, I kind of look stupid the other three times.
Well, you know what? You're setting a precedent for what forever means to you. So he's more right than these other people.
I was at this guy's house, the parents' house, and they have like 17 toasters. Good for them.
It's so good.
Yeah.
Hey, can I?
It's a registering Ponzi scheme. Right.
Can I pitch an idea to the half Jew?
Yeah, I want all my guests to be comfortable.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Half Jew.
Yeah. Hit me with it.
I have an idea for a movie, and you can write this.
Oh, I can.
But we put my name on it.
Okay. Great.
It's a,
loving this so far.
It's a billionaire.
Okay.
Who is.
Played by Adam Sandler, of course.
You're
right.
Okay.
I mean, yeah.
Very smart. Adam and he.
Him does should get story credit on this.
Oh, yes. Shit. Oh, shit.
Seven. He's going through his seventh divorce.
Okay.
With the same female divorce attorney.
Okay.
And he begins to realize that the only reason he keeps getting married and divorced is he's in love with this divorce attorney.
David, is this a script idea or a confession?
Well, first of all, my question to you is, has there been a movie already made like that?
I can't think of a single movie with that plot.
Also, does it matter?
That's right. Good point.
I mean,
once we have the Sandman on board, it doesn't matter.
Okay, so can you write that for me and put my name on it?
I will put it under consideration.
All right.
Just understand that at some point,
sure.
The billionaire has to go, gobbledygoo!
Sold.
I messed up again!
Sorry,
those are the three lines he speaks the entire movie.
Sorry, I just had to go make $3 million.
No, sure, I understand. You're the idea, man.
When Harry Met Sally Esquire.
Has that idea been done?
I don't think so.
It definitely never won an Oscar.
Has that idea been done?
No. There's that movie with Pierce Brosnan where he's a divorce attorney who dates another divorce attorney.
Nah, that's different.
So do you want to write that?
I'll write that.
It's Welcome. Kind of like the J-Lo movie where she's the maid in the hotel.
Maid in Manhattan.
Yeah.
If this is...
No, it's not like that. I watched that
movie. Falls in love with the maid.
This other Jew did not watch that, clearly.
What happens in that movie?
Nothing. J-Lo goes, look, I'm a normal person. We're like, we see you, J-Lo.
Wow. That's bad dialogue.
That's terrible.
She will not get a story credit.
Yeah.
Rescinded.
Now it's all mine.
You lost it, atheist.
Fuck. That's J-Lo's every character. She's like... Look at me. I'm just this humble little person. Sure. What's that? The most eligible man in town wants to get together with me? I deny you, for you will never love me, for I am just a mere little mortal.
No,
what's that? You want to pursue it for 2 hours? Oh, man. I'm creaming my pants. We're going to have mediocre sex. Oh, yay. Wedding time. Did you write that down?
Yeah, Brenda from the block.
Every last word. bird.
Oh, hi, mate. I think you're pretty. I would like to take you out.
Just me? No. You must have thought it was someone else because I was wearing your clothes for a minute, but I can't tell you that, so I guess I'll go on a date with you.
I'm going to put my suitcase down because I mean it. Let's go out tonight.
My goodness. But what should I wear?
My phone's ringing. I'm ignoring it. Sorry, I'm finally focused on something real.
Wow. A missed phone call just for me. I feel like my dreams are coming true.
Look, I just blew the big deal. Who cares? Let's go on a date. Millionaires just lost all their money, and the board's going to evaporate.
Yes,
oh, well.
But I'm going to have the most perfect wedding, and let's face it, that's all that matters. The end.
The end of that movie is that relationship causes the financial collapse.
Right.
I can't believe it's 2008. The end.
Have you ever seen a movie?
Excuse me for 1 second.
Yeah.
Credit roll, Liza Minnelli sings at your wedding.
Oh, ooh. Yes. All single ladies.
For no reason.
For the
right.
Credit roll.
Yeah, for no reason, I'm bringing up Liza Minnelli's name. See you in an hour and a half. Oh, look, she's here. My favorite song was by Biz Markie. Biz Markie is here an hour and a half later. What?
He's just a friend.
I remember that song.
Hey, you know what I was thinking? If I ever get married again, the song I want to dance to is the one Lady Gaga sang at the Oscars.
Which one is that?
It was an anti-rape song.
Oh. He is cracking himself
He's
up.
He's having a good time.
Just understand that David is having the best time right now.
Because I was watching Lady Gaga. I'm like, I was upset by that song.
I honestly thought you were going to say.
Good saved.
I am.
But it's a serious issue.
Right. Look into it. Everything should be consensual. Okay. Now, with that said, I'm busting
well done,
a knot.
I was upset by the song. Because I thought it really slowed the show down. No, I was upset. But I did say to myself, boy, that would be funny if somebody said, I wanted that to be my first dance at my wedding.
Right.
It just was. So congrats.
But that's what we do, Gabe.
Yeah.
Right?
Jim? Wait, why did I say yeah to that?
No.
No, David. That's not what we do.
No, you see something sad.
Sure.
Right.
You say something.
And you think of something worse. That's where comedy, I think, comes from, is like, this is bad.
Right.
Let me think of something that's even worse, and the bad thing becomes funny instead of sad.
That's why you're a billionaire.
And then they arrested everybody in Seinfeld. Remember? Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Why? What was that?
So AIDS.
That's the last episode.
Go.
Here's the thing about AIDS. Do you believe 9/11 was an inside job?
It was the best writer's room ever.
Oh, that was the movie I was going to bring up. There's a movie called Remember Me or something with Robert Pattinson from like 5 years ago. And the whole thing, it's just
He marries his divorce attorney?
Yeah, he marries a divorce attorney.
And really?
But it's just like a boring romantic drama the whole way through. But then at the end of the movie, he's just in a building like they're on the rocks, but they're going to try to make it work. And he's in a building and he just looks out. And then the camera pans out to show he's in the Twin Towers. And it cuts to a classroom and a teacher we have not met in the movie before is talking to a classroom and says, "Now, class, what's today's date?" And then she writes September 11th.
Ew, drive it home.
And what happens to him?
And then Liza Minnelli.
He's okay.
Plays? Is it understood that the plane's going to crash into the building then?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Robert Pattinson.
Ah, that's funny.
Who played? Good. Why is everybody acting like that's stupid? I wish more movies
Tony Shalhoub played Muhammad Atta in that movie. Tony Shalhoub did a killer Muhammad Atta in that movie. He was phenomenal. He was like Monk, but terroristy.
He had to keep touching the handle five times. He has OCD, I guess. I never saw the show.
Uh-huh.
Monk, what are our thoughts? David.
Best show on television.
Yeah?
Andy Breckman, my friend, created that.
Look at this.
Yeah, and he's been on the show.
It's a small world.
You met Andy Breckman.
Yeah, Andy's great.
Mind you, met him.
We worked with Andy Breckman.
We did work with Andy.
What was it? Remember, he would sit and literally.
He's one of the funniest people I've ever studied.
But in terms of story structure and stuff?
Yeah, he would see a story for the first time and then break it down immediately and restructure it.
It's pretty intimidating. He may be.
Kinda just took the Jew's pen away.
Yeah.
The most powerful instrument he has for banging it on the desk.
It's my greatest strength.
Right.
We're name dropping. names that nobody's ever heard of. Which is very, that's a good way to name drop, by the way.
Because nobody will know if you're telling the truth.
Right.
You're like, I believe you. Good for
There's
you.
There's no such thing as Andy Breckman. There was never a show called Monk. And you invented Tony Shalhoub.
I did. Not a real person.
No, but it's a great punchline. The name Shalhoub is funny.
Yeah.
How did you guys meet?
Well, we were in a bar, and he overheard me talking about the funniest names. Banana. That's funny. And then the next thing you know, we're pals.
We danced at a wedding to a rape song. And the rest
in that rise
is history. To a rape anthem.
Oh, it wasn't in just like the regular Jew meetings?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We met at the Bible breakfast. No, we met. I remember when we met. It was.
Was that Luna Lounge?
No, it was the summer of 2001. We're at the meeting on whether or not the Twin Towers should come down.
Yeah,
it was the Jew meeting.
Now where are we going to go to Hoboken and watch it.
Yeah, and throw the
with
party
with the rest of our people.
You were supposed to bring a camera and videotape. We hired people to dress like Muslims, and they were going to dance as the towers came down, and you forgot to bring the camera.
It was glorious plan.
Yeah, and you forgot to bring the camera, so Trump...
did see something, but there's no proof.
Yeah.
Well, his little hands. He couldn't work the controls on them.
By the way, speaking of tweets, I'm seeing, David, you are not a Trump supporter. It's not, at least it's not coming off that way.
I love Donald Trump.
Well, it seems that words are important, David.
I love Donald Trump because I hate this country. And we deserve it. We deserve Donald Trump.
Really?
Yeah, I think we're a stupid people. And this is, we sat back and ate bad food and smoked pot and watched television.
This is because of the pot, isn't it? And Reefer Madness.
And we deserve Donald Trump.
Hey, guys, Rubio said Trump had small hands. You remember that?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, imagine how huge they make his tiny dick look.
What?
What? Up top, too.
Dude, what the fuck?
Wow, that's a good one. Did you just come up with that?
Yes, I did. Yes, I did.
That's a great joke. That's a great joke.
It's all in huge.
That's a great joke.
Yeah, I had that.
That's amazing. Oof.
The Jew came through. It's not a competition.
It's not a competition.
It's starting to feel like a competition.
No.
It is a competition.
I have like 10 here about Trump University. Just saying.
Ooh.
If that wants to be brought up.
Hey, I got some thoughts on Trump University. Did you know I studied at Trump University?
No, I didn't.
Yeah, I earned a master race degree. What the fuck is going on in this environment?
Wait a second. These are better than the jokes I gave you.
What? No.
That's a great...
Trump loves Hitler so much, he even emulated his dick size. They have tiny pranks. Yeah.
I would just like to point out that your Jew has a fucking laptop and my Jew has a stupid pen
Jew,
and paper.
I'll work on some.
No. Relax, yeah. Jew. He's been doing this. He's been prepping for...
Hey, seriously, though, we talk about Trump University. It's not easy to get into. You really need to score high on your SSATs. That's a Nazi thing. See, Kyle. Yeah. Trump has his own university. He got the idea from his hero, Duke. Yeah. David Duke, I bet.
Yeah, Duke University.
Duke University.
Yeah, that's a thinker. That's like David's phlegm joke.
Yeah, it's not right.
I like that.
It works on the paper.
Let me try again.
Wait a second.
Hey, Trump has his own university. He got the idea from his hero, Duke.
Well, you know, they're a green university. They've gone green.
Yeah.
I'm getting slow down. I'm getting intimidated by my Jew.
Well,
much better jokes than I could have ever written.
Well, we work together better. All this talk about Trump's dick. Yeah, okay. You know, small dick. Did you know he's circumcised? Yeah. Now the only hood he's got on is the one he wears over his fucking head. This is a KKK president.
God damn it.
I'm out. That's it.
Wait a second.
That's all I got now.
Those are great. The whole idea of this was for me to sit back.
You have to encourage
David,
your writers.
SSATs is an awful joke.
No. I was trying him to help me out here. Yeah. The whole idea
was... Let me see what my fucking Jew wrote.
I was going to say... Hey, no. Don't forget him. This is a problem.
Hey, Trump's a prick and he's got a small one. What? It's like, why are we measuring dicks? okay, you show me yours, I'll show you mine. That's like dick pic humor. Hey, send me a sext. That's pretty good, Jew.
Thank you.
It's pretty good.
I've had those in my back pocket for a while.
You know, we got to aim it at the right time.
Oh, he just drew a picture of a dick on a piece of paper. I don't know. Go with that.
I speak Jew. We all know what that means.
I'm having a spiritual crisis, Chemda.
I'm glad you came to me.
I started the show by subsuming my ego, and now it turns out you guys are better guest hosts than I am of my own show, and this Jew over here writes better jokes.
Let me tell you this. It's all a reflection of you. If you weren't in the room, who would we make fun of?
No, I feel like shit. I'm nothing.
You're nothing?
I'm nothing.
That's where good jokes come from.
Those jokes were much. I could never write a joke as good as that Jew.
David, speaking of Trump University, 4 years at Trump University, you really have to savor the time, you know, because if you tremblinka, you'll miss it. That's a concentration camp, I understand.
What? What are we talking about? Oh, shit, Bach.
If you tremblinka, you'll miss the whole experience.
You tremblinka.
Yeah.
Hey, it's like.
I got Auschwitz face last night.
Yeah, you really get Auschwitz faced at the fraternity party at Trump University.
Hey, it's like, why can't Trump take a shower to get that orange off his skin? Is he like scared of showers for some reason?
Do you know where Trump University is? It's in Bergen-Belsen, New Jersey.
Near Fairleigh Dickinson.
He liked it. The guy with the question mark on his ass.
What's up, Dan?
Dan liked it.
We laugh about the Holocaust because it was funny. Go ahead.
Next year in Jerusalem.
I mean, because no more Holocaust jokes. No more Holocaust jokes.
No, is that the quota?
You're better at it than I am.
I just know a lot of names of concentration camps so that I can use as puns. I don't know if I know a lot.
Okay.
All right. Seriously. I'm so be boring, all of you guys. All That's right. a deep cut.
That's it.
No, camp so be boring. That was a tough one. They escaped from that one.
Thank you.
I watch National Geographic Channel way too much.
See, I have to take... He's better at Holocaust jokes than I am, so I have to take the moral high ground. There's nothing funny about this. I wish you would stop.
Please stick to the rape jokes. Okay. Thank you.
You've really crossed the line. You've really offended me.
Rape jokes. I mean, it's like Woody Allen, huh? Good job, Jew.
Thank you. We got that motherfucker.
Woody Allen, did he rape his stepdaughter? Yes or no? David Feldman.
We're going around the room, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm a big Woody Allen fan, so I like it. I like to think he did. Take that out of the
but
show,
just for
Alex.
The joke?
We'll cut that out. No, I don't think he did.
Okay, good.
You really don't?
No.
What?
She's just making it up?
I think people have vivid imaginations.
That's what we go to? We imagine adults diddling us?
Women are sick. And you have weird imaginations.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's what does it for me.
Bill Cosby. Thoughts? David Feldman.
Then women we'll go, have huge imaginations.
And then we'll go around the room. David?
Bill Cosby, I think.
I picture you laughing in your sleep.
I think if he wanted a woman to be unresponsive during sex, I could have given him my second wife. I don't know why he needed to take a quaalude. I panicked.
All right, so we're up to two. This is what I'm following. Okay.
Okay. Who
He's
else?
Guilty. He's guilty.
He's guilty. All right. Who else?
OJ.
Yeah.
OJ Simpson.
They found the knife.
We'll go around the room. We'll start with David Feldman. OJ Simpson.
I actually think my Jew. Who I've lent you right. came up with the best joke.
Well, he's a good guy.
About OJ's knife.
I'll tell you in 2 seconds.
Because it was on Good Morning America today.
It was my tweet got used in the coverage on GMA of the knife being found.
My guy's so. World famous.
It's such a wholesome.
It was amazing.
Show.
I didn't watch it. Somebody sent me the screenshot, but the joke.
You just want to be clear that you didn't watch it.
Right, right.
I don't even have time to see it. I'm too busy writing jokes. If you guys see my stuff on TV, tell me, I guess, if it makes you happy.
If they find the knife, he killed his wife. Lesser known Johnny Cochran rhyme.
Ace is 10.
Hey now.
Ace is 10. That should be on the nightly news.
There you go.
GMA really finds the big stories.
Thanks for the shout out.
Do you watch? We'll go around the room, but let's start with David Feldman on this one. Do you watch that show, The People vs. O.J. Simpson?
I have Hulu.
Okay.
and humble it's brag. Not running.
Is it on Hulu? I don't know what he's saying.
He's like, I have two cars. With that said, I have not seen the show.
I drink OJ.
Right.
Does that count?
And I stabbed my wife and took her head clear off. With it. He did take the head clear off.
What?
Yeah. They were almost decapitated.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really?
Is that
true? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I don't remember that. Was that in the TV show? I thought they were just laying outside. I go by the TV show.
Grizzly.
They didn't show it so grizzly. Yeah. That's my thoughts.
I have not seen it because I watched all my first run TV shows on Hulu and they haven't gotten around to it yet.
Wait, how are you watching it?
We steal everything. I don't know. We get it. We just get stuff.
My wife does things my and then I sit.
No, I think whatever it's on, I think we have. Is it on Amazon or Netflix?
It's on FX.
Oh, it's on FX. How do we get it then? I think we get on Hulu through FX.
FX is not running, and I'd like to discuss this for 20 more minutes. I don't think Hulu is running OJ right now.
Well, then obviously I'm lying, David.
Okay.
I mean, torrent it. I don't know what I do. I'm watching it.
Okay. Is it good?
I don't know. I've never seen it.
It will win all of the Emmys. And really? I don't say that facetiously. It will win all of the Emmys. It's cringeworthy bad, but in the best possible way.
They over-explain things, which is good. More TV shows should do that. They're like, lawyer Johnny Cochran, who's working with me on this case, how are you this morning? And it's like, oh, yeah, it's Johnny Cochran. I remember. And then he goes, it's me, Johnny Cochran. I'm going home now from working on this case. And I was like, oh, yeah, Johnny from the early one. There's two black people. Thanks for being clear, you know.
I like it.
Hey, that's but no exaggeration. They'll say, for example, who's the Kardashian mom?
Oh.
Chris.
Yeah, Chris.
Chris Jenner. And it'd be like, hey, Chris Jenner, that's Robert Kardashian. You just had a divorce with him. And she's like, yeah, I did. Should I let him around the kids, Kim, Chloe, and the other one? And then I'm like, oh, yeah, now I know who everybody is. That's fun. You talk like weirdos, but I like it.
They're narrating their whole life.
If they made it more clear in these Holocaust shows, I wouldn't know half those fucking references I was reading.
The Kardashian scenes are the most trolling.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
that's what I heard.
It's the best. It's just like, you should never care about being on TV. It's just about family. And then, like, they look at the camera
and give a wink.
Like, is there also a sound like,
but they really do. Robert Kardashian's with the kids and saying, you know, this trial is already turning into a circus. It didn't even start yet. Remember, you know, some lesson on fame not being important, being a good person is coming out of nowhere. And Kim Kardashian all but rolls her eyes. It's like, yeah, right. I'm bored. Waffle fries. You're like, you're going to turn into a bitch.
Can I ask you a question?
You know what? Okay. No, that's fair. We'll go around the room. We'll start with David Feldman.
Okay. And by the way, you are the best guest host.
Thank you.
We've ever had on this show.
Thank you very much.
I'm appreciating you more as a co-host.
Thank you.
So I feel like you revived our show.
Right. 11 years. Here's to another 2 months.
Well, have you been doing it 11 years?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just celebrated.
March 7th.
Why don't you tell, we've had you on the show before talking about Keith and the girl.
And we don't repeat ourselves, so.
Okay, so let me ask you a question about Caitlyn Jenner. Okay? And I have to do my preamble just to show that I'm on the right side of history.
Okay.
I know two trans people. They're my friends. I've had lunch with one of them, the other one coffee, so I can talk about trans people. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you. Because it's something I don't understand, right?
Sure.
Yes, you are right.
The closest I get to understanding is the hair transplants. Like I look in the mirror and I like seeing my hair transplants, despite how uncomfortable everybody else around me is.
I think they love it. They're always joking about it. They love it. You're not making anybody uncomfortable.
So I get the idea. Like I, spent 20 some odd years walking around Hollywood and Beverly Hills. You'd go for lunch and you'd see these women with their faces pulled back and you'd go, they like the way they look, you know, and you get used to it and you accept it. You accept that there's a race of creatures with their faces.
The cat people, yeah.
Pulled all the way back to the point where, I mean, I've seen facelifts.
Those are just the women OJ mutilated.
Do you think they like it, by the way? Or do you think somebody got it,
the facelift on. They look like a cat. It's disgusting. But then Misery Loves Company, they convince somebody else. And the next thing you know, you're the only normal-looking person at brunch with a bunch of weirdos. Right. And you see them. You're a Meg Ryan, and you're like, this is disgusting, but they don't include you in the parties until you look like them. Right. Do you think Meg Ryan looks in the mirror and goes, I am so pretty right. now?
I think she does. I saw a woman in Beverly Hills whose facelift was so tight, her belches sounded like a queef.
I feel bad for Meg Ryan because she got all that plastic surgery before.
One second, really, David's taking a bow.
Oh, yes.
Uh-huh. She got all the plastic surgery before
her belches sounded like, wait a second, Jew. Hang on for one second. Her belches sounded like a queef. I don't get anything from you. You know, that wasn't funny?
No, I loved it.
I was desperate.
You're doing a lot of sound jokes today.
Okay, go ahead.
You know it's your job to be funny, right?
I'm intimidated by my Jew.
Anytime you say queef, I'm in your corner, buddy.
Right. So my apologies. You
but no, I was just saying that I feel bad for Meg Ryan because she clearly got all the plastic surgery before all the good plastic surgery was invented.
Right.
Because like now you can, like Kardashians, they've all had it and they're beautiful.
Right.
They've had it in their 20s. There's nothing to do. They're having fake jobs. Like that's...
Meg Ryan got it in like 89 when they were still using...
All right, I don't think it's... First of all, I think in all honesty... I think
you're hoping to have her on the podcast? So.
I think you should go back to Holocaust jokes. I'm offended by Meg Ryan joke. That's mean. I can look past...
They didn't kidnap her and do that to her face. Well, she paid for it.
Now when she has an orgasm at Katz's Deli, it sounds like a queef.
Nice! Go. I love it! God damn, you're funny. It's the way you say it.
I'm going to shut up now. I'm done. I think I was silent last time.
It's like, can I have the queef she's having? Good job, Jew.
Estelle Reiner. I'll have the queef she's having.
The roast queef.
At Katz's Deli.
My Jew is killing it.
When Harry met Sally.
corn queef.
Okay. Don't you think? I don't want to talk about anybody in specifically, but you know, it's a form of cutting in that women are so abused in Hollywood. You know, you cut yourself because I'm a cutter. I like to cut because it's the only part of my life that I can control. Seeing the blood.
I knew you were going to name names.
I'm a cutter. I go home after the show. I'll feel bad and I'll just sit with a razor and just cut my body. And I go, there's blood coming out of my skin. Right. I'm totally out of control of my life, but this is something I can control. I can control the pain. I can control the blood. I'm a cutter. And I think...
Hold on. Is this true?
I can't tell.
You have this smile on the whole time.
I'm joking.
Oh, okay.
I'm the most boring person in the world.
I don't even cut. I'm so boring.
I don't do anything.
I'm so old. I can't get with the millennial diseases.
Occasionally.
Cutting.
I mean, the closest I come to being a little kinky is I'll pick up a runaway at the Port Authority and kill him and put him in my trunk and dump him.
I like that he's comparing cutting to, like, but sexual.
That's the closest I come to anything remotely kinky.
But again, I can't tell if you're serious.
No, what I'm saying is that the reason women especially cut is they want control.
Okay.
And I think
that I want a perfect body. Right?
Lady Gaga.
No, that's what's his name? Radiohead. Anyway,
I'm sorry.
Song.
I totally threw you.
David's just stuck in Radiohead thoughts now. There are five members of the band. They originated in.
But I think women in Hollywood go to plastic surgeons for the same reason they cut themselves. It's the only thing they can control.
I see.
I think we talk about them when they have lines around their eyes, and then we talk about them when they get rid of it, and then we talk about it. It's like you can't win. It's a catch-22. You're trying to keep in a career where everyone's taking over your job and be relevant, and it's like an unfair... Anyway, Jew, what are you up to? Why am I saying this shit? Right. What the fuck? Yes. How did
half
we get
Jew.
On this platform?
Half Jew. He's a half Jew.
And my mom does a lot of cutting, but it's mostly brisket.
What?
I'm not giving you a high five. What are you, now I'm intimidated by you. Now I'm how did I meet you?
Jesus.
Yes, it was a beautiful like spring
morning.
We were
at that cutting seminar. How to do it and hide it. From all of your
loved
ones.
That's where you got all your Auschwitz jokes with the hiding.
Yeah. Anyway, back to Caitlyn Jenner.
Yes.
Is it possible, because I was reading, I don't mean to take the show away.
No, but I encourage my guests to talk, to form opinions. That's the point of a panel.
Okay.
We'll start with David Feldman.
Okay. So I'm again, the preamble, blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. Some of my best friends are, blah, blah, blah. But Caitlyn Jenner is talking about...
That's all the time for now, David. Thank you.
How she wants to work for Ted Cruz, and she's against gay marriage, and she's a Republican.
She's an asshole. I don't understand why we give her so much credit.
She's a trans Republican.
She's a fucking asshole. She killed someone the same year that she won Best Woman. We finally saw some transgender person change before our eyes, except she didn't. She changed, you know, she has all this money, and that's fine. She got the sex change, and that's wonderful, and it's a platform, and it's, you know, showing people something of what trans is. But trans people aren't like, yay, Caitlyn Jenner is our fucking god. She's a terrible person. Let's not forget, she's part of
goddess.
This
goddess. We say goddess now.
Oh, sorry. I apologize. Right. Yes. Let's not forget that she's one of these Kardashians. She's, you know, they've all been using us to, like, make money. And mm-hmm. I don't understand why she's such a hero. I get it that it's like, this is a difficult thing to do. It is a difficult, in this time, it is difficult to transition openly. It's difficult to not transition. It's just difficult to be a trans person. But to make her the leader of this fucking movement, go fuck yourself. I don't give a shit. Yes, Jew.
So my question...
Oh, yes.
I'm glad
but
you
But do you know that what bothers me about it is that she only transitioned, it seems, to get out of that court case. She's in the court of law, and they're like, oh, you're up for manslaughter. And she's like, Bruce? Who's Bruce? I don't see a Bruce. And they're like, this missed.
Yeah,
you know.
He was right. Stick to the Auschwitz jokes.
Hey, by the way, speaking of Caitlyn Jenner, in the series finale of The People vs. O.J. Simpson, O.J.'s visited by Caitlyn Jenner. I don't know if you heard. Played by Mariska Hargitay. I don't know who that is.
Oh, she looks like Mariska Hargitay.
That's a Law and Order joke.
Now, here's something really interesting.
That's some Law and Order humor.
I don't have a joke, but if people remembered history, mm-hmm. her mother could have played Nicole Simpson. Do you know why?
Mariska Hargitay's mother?
Is?
Mrs. Hargitay.
Doubtfire.
Okay, what happened? Earlier in the show, we talked about the head coming clear off.
Yes.
Right? Mariska Hargitay's mother was?
Dead and decapitated.
Jane Mansfield.
From the Mansons.
No, Jane Mansfield, the...
The famous actress we all love and adore.
Was she decapitated? Wait, I want to know.
Wait, Jane Mansfield was the poor man's Marilyn Monroe.
Okay.
And she was buxom and...
I'm waiting until we all get it and we just fucking die laughing.
and she was in a car accident.
Oh.
And her head came clear off.
Nice.
And so...
It's ironic. I didn't even know that. Look at the layers of my terrible
Now choice. I get it! Jay Mansfield! You guys will get it.
I don't have the joke. I just have the...
No, I got
it's
it.
It's ironic.
That you said that Caitlyn Jenner... In the O.J. movie, would be played. Let me just explain the joke. Would be played by Mariska Hargitay because she looks like Mariska Hargitay.
My friend regrets writing that joke so much. worst movie ever made.
And then I say, you know, given that Nicole Simpson's head came
what
clear off.
What the hell am I doing here?
Because earlier, what's the band we mentioned earlier? Radiohead, right?
The role of Nicole Simpson could have been played by Mariska Hargitay's mother. And if people knew that Jane Mansfield was...
It would have been... It would have crushed.
That's...
Wrong crowd.
There's a thin... There's a thin line between comedy genius...
And teaching somebody what a joke is like they're 2 years old.
Yeah. It's like... And that's where you... I have a beautiful mind. And I'm lost in my own... Like, I could mathematically explain a lot of these jokes. Mm-hmm. But then I'd be, you know...
Too smart.
Sure.
All right, we'll go around the room, but we'll start with David
Feldman. So
my question is,
if would you agree that Republicans, mm-hmm. this is a syllogism, all Republicans are insane, right? If you're a member of the Republican Party right now, you're insane. So is it possible that Caitlyn Jenner is not a man trapped in a woman trapped in a man's body,
but just crazy?
Just crazy. Can you be crazy and just decide, you know what? I was born in the wrong body.
But what's the point of that? Let's say a small percentage of people who identify as trans people are actually crazy.
The point is, I want my country back.
Okay, Trump.
I want to go back to a better time when America was great.
Yeah, that's not fair. I mean,
disabuse me of this reptilian brain.
What's the difference? Like, I feel, I don't know if this is the right comparison, but, you know, the way that people are like, oh, Muslims, they're responsible for ISIS. No, you're all saying, you know, maybe the word Muhammad in your tactics, in your logic, in your, you know, beliefs, but one is not the same as the other. One is using it for evil, one is using it for wrong, one is not... does not represent this other thing. So even if there are crazy people who claim a lot of things, there are crazy people who think they're joke writers and podcasters and comedians.
Oh, that's
do you want to indulge in that?
Well,
I mean,
what about this as a white male
up top? I'm with you.
I'm all for change.
I don't think you are.
I am. Mm-hmm. But what about asking for permission first?
Mm-hmm.
Before
from just, mommy just run, or from David Feldman
running it by I think
we should be able to vote on it.
Mm-hmm. Just the white men, you know, we're the power structure and we're all for what everybody wants, but just run it by us first. Right. To see if we're okay with it, and ask us how long it's going to take us to accept some of this stuff.
I think we do, and then we and then we put you in the corner and do it anyway. Just like we did when we understood that our parents are wrong. We said, okay, that's enough. We're going to take over now.
But don't you think that the Trump rallies, that those people just really, they just want to be just run it by them. Just explain it to them, and then they'll be okay with it.
I think they're ready to hear anything. You explain anything to them any which way, and they'll go that way. He says bullshit like, the Mexican president is going to pay for the wall. Cut to the Mexican president going, fuck you, no, I won't. And he's like, no, he will. He will. And his followers are like, he explained it. It's totally going to happen that way.
What is that?
That's their boss does the same thing to them. Look, I'm going to, you know, you do this job. But, no, you do this job, and then everything will be great. And then you just, like, day in and day out at your stupid job where people are taking advantage of you. But you're like, no, it's the boss. He gives me a check. Yeah, he's supposed to give you a check. That isn't making America great. That's just working.
But before you, I think I'm stumbling into something.
Okay. Do people know we already have a fence, by the way? Everybody's scared of a wall. We already kind of have a wall, don't we?
Do we?
Don't we?
I don't know.
We can't just walk to Mexico.
I thought white men were supposed to know all of this. Do we have a fence or a wall?
Do you... Again, I apologize for...
Forgiven. No, that's what I encourage here on the David Feldman Show.
Wouldn't we be doing a service to the idiots in this country? And by the idiots in this country, I mean the 99%. The 99% of to run these ideas by them before you introduce them to the general populace.
Yes, we just haven't figured out a way how to do that. How do we do it?
Snapchat.
Yeah. I mean, there are enough, like, you know, WB shows, right? I think they were trying to get through to everybody through those shows. I think that's how Trump got where he is.
When you have your Ted Cruz and these ones, and they're so religiously evil, why don't we like Trump better than those people if he's just wishy-washy and saying whatever? Why not have somebody goofy instead of somebody that we know where they stand, and it's fucking dead wrong?
David Feldman. I love Trump.
Okay.
I
got to be clear in your tweets. It really looks like you hate him. it's not coming across.
I think he's... we're playing a game of chicken in this country, right, if you're a liberal. That is, the Republican Party deserves Trump. He is, as Stephen King kind of intimated, he's the Frankenstein that these guys created. He's saying either what the Republicans believe or what they feel, and then articulating what they're not allowed to say.
I mean, Stephen King also said he liked that horrible movie, The Witch. So,
okay.
Take it for what it's worth.
Did you not like The Witch?
I despise it.
He doesn't know. He sees all the movies, and 90% of them happen to be bad.
I've not seen that one. I've heard it's very good.
I love women, but there's only like 10 awesome ones. You know what I mean?
Thanks, Keith.
Yeah.
That sounds gay to me. Only 10?
That sounds trans to me. I don't know.
You only think there are 10 awesome women?
You know, I'm not the one going through all these divorces. Yes, there's only a couple.
I forgot what we were talking about.
Caitlyn Jenner, Donald Trump being fun to be president, Miley Cyrus.
Oh, Trump.
We were talking about the Republican field, and mm-hmm. it's a game of chicken.
Chicken hawk.
Chicken shit.
Chicken shit.
That's where you guys
where
met.
Where are you?
You guys met at a word association class.
$25,000 pyramid.
Chicken.
Chicken.
Shit.
I would like chicken.
The password is chicken.
I love that show.
The chicken hawks have come home to roost in the Republican Party. That's the point I'm making.
All right. Po-yo.
Tweet that.
He's comedy royalty, by the way.
I know.
He's pointing at my Jew.
He's my man.
Tell where you, how you started in the business.
Say how you're famous.
Tell him about Nick Lachey.
Tell him why you're the best.
No, tell them.
I'll email everyone my resume.
No, yeah. Tell them. No, no.
Just send me your email.
He has a television pedigree. Mm-hmm. Tell them your first job in television.
You watch The West Wing?
Of course.
No, tell
you
them.
Were I, the West. You were the hallway.
No, I was an NBC page.
He was an NBC page. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That is television royalty. Explain why it's television royalty.
Because you get the suit.
You wear a uniform.
What color was the suit? Yellow?
Blue jacket, gray pants, right. Peacock tie.
Nice.
And you give the studio tours.
Right.
And at that time, it was Conan, Rosie, SNL.
Dateline
with Stone Phillips.
Did you make up facts? Were you like, this is what they eat for
breakfast
every morning?
You know, this is a true story. You come in and there's like tried and true, like passed down sort of like jokes and stuff that everybody makes that you learn from the page that trained you. I was so disgusted with the jokes that me and another buddy of mine who came in sort of at the same time, we rewrote the whole thing.
That's funny. Awesome.
And we put in our all new material.
That's great. What's one of your faves?
Oh, man. I mean, we used to go and talk.
By the way, I have a joke, but I'm going to wait. And then
good for you. It should be noted
that I have
that
something.
He did not interrupt. In
I'm
fact,
I'm learning.
I do have something that I'm trying to shoehorn into his.
I'm gonna wrap up. I just
no, keep going. I just want to point out that I'm being polite.
You're very mature. Yes,
yeah. That I could interrupt you right now with a joke that I could shoehorn in, but I'm gonna wait to the end. And then it's just going to seem like
this guy is a mensch.
It's just going to be a witness.
Mensch on a bench.
The new Jesus.
I'll just tell you, we used to go in nightly news and bring the tour in, and you'd have Tom Brokaw's desk there, and there'd always be his mug on the desk. And in the tour, you'd be like, and this is where Tom Brokaw sits. This is where he does the news. This is his mug. And you'd lift it up, and you'd be like, this is where he drinks his water. Whoa, that's not water. it would kill.
Yeah. Is that one that you guys wrote? That's a new one?
Kill, yeah. Oh.
Is that handed down?
It's not new anymore.
Is that a joke that's handed down? Because like
no, that was one that we started doing.
Do you remember any of the bad ones they gave you?
Oh, I mean, I don't, not really, but they were pretty bad.
Do not drink from that cup. Tom Brokaw is a drunk.
Tom Brokaw has
a problem.
Don't drink from that cup. He made out with Tony Bennett, but that's.
But Tom Brokaw did get the anthrax. That's who it was sent to. That's a true story. But the Dateline NBC studio used to have a staircase that was just for show.
Sure.
And we'd be like, and this is where Stone Phillips slides down the banister.
Great.
Like, that was like one that everyone was using. And I was like, I refuse to do it.
Was there ever an asshole in the group?
Always.
Like, what's an asshole thing to do?
Anyone in a wheelchair. It's so inconvenient. It's the worst.
Stair joke isn't funny to them.
Get out. You're not allowed.
Did you see the swastikas?
No, you asked me that before. I know nothing about this.
What?
But you're the Holocaust guy.
There are swastikas in Rockefeller Center on the beams, correct?
Yes.
You told me about this. This is amazing.
Tell them.
I don't know. This is not in the guidebook.
Why did I teach you?
Please.
Tell the nice people.
Tell the people. By the way, I have a joke that I'm holding back.
Right. Oh, God, this is going to be so
good. You can see the vein in his head.
Yeah, yeah.
Filling with the joke.
I understand that when you are, in a group.
Right, you're doing great.
And I'm just, holding
you're
back.
You're one
the
of
joke.
The guys.
I'll tell you one story.
Tell them about the swastika.
I don't know. You know about the swastika.
When was Rockefeller Center built?
1920 Nazi.
In the 20s, right?
In the late 20s, early 30s.
Right.
And
I forget the fact that you told me last time.
And the steel came from
Jew skin.
Exactly. No, it came from Nazi Germany.
Nazi steel.
It is still the best steel. I mean, Pittsburgh can't come up with better.
If Hitler did one thing well, it was steel manufacturing.
Yes,
he did. There were two things: steel manufacturing, and the other thing he got
annihilation of the.
No, he got one thing right. My Uncle Mitch.
He got, Mitch is why that's funny.
Uh-huh. My uncle, funny. Hitler got one thing right about my Uncle Mitch. My Uncle Mitch was an a-hole.
Yeah, the Nazis,
so
it
was built with Nazis.
We follow.
Yeah, we get it.
Uncle Mitch.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's rest Mitchie. In peace. Yeah.
That's amazing.
But
let me just tell you one.
If you could just stretch it a little.
Yeah.
Right. His stand-up is like 6 hours long because he tells the joke and then makes sure everybody got it.
Well, this is second row.
Okay, okay.
I'm more successful with podcasting than stand-up because I get to explain why my jokes are funny. Sometimes the
there's
audience,
an after show where you just explain everything.
The audience, I believe that the...
Chris Hardwick hosts it.
Yeah.
So no, but it was made with Nazi steel.
He was going to tell it. Share the story.
It's just you know.
And by the way, go back to your story. I still have his joke.
As a page, you used to work on all the shows. It's so SNL, you know, whatever, and all kinds of famous people would come see the show live, and you'd take them up and down in the elevator. And Monica Lewinsky was there to see the show.
Oh, I have another joke.
No, this is fertile ground. That's why I'm telling it. And I was the one that
going down.
That's it. So I escorted her
going down.
She walked in the elevator.
I'm the president of the United States.
And it took everything I had not to be like going down, Miss Lewinsky.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You're all amazing.
I'm sorry. That was your punchline?
Yeah.
Okay.
But no, it's the obvious punchline, but I'm just saying.
I'm going to see if anybody was holding on to a joke.
Explain
I'm
gonna
that go
one.
Around, I'm going to go around
Monica
the
Monica Lewinsky
explain
went
the joke,
down.
Because a lot of young kids may not get this. Go ahead.
Monica Lewinsky was a White House intern who flashed her thong one day to the president. Mm-hmm. And he had to have it.
Yeah, sometimes.
And
cigar had to have it.
Yeah, so she blew him in the Oval Office.
Huh. Did that become a thing?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, all the presidents are doing it now.
I'm going to need the...
It's actually good fodder for Beyonce's
Taft.
Songs.
Taft got so much intern put.
All right. By the way, you were an NBC page?
Yes, sir.
Do you know why...
Royalty.
Do you know why I've been standing for the past show?
Why is that?
Because I was a congressional page. That's the joke I was holding on to. Does anybody get that?
I actually need the explanation.
Let me do it. You know what? I never thought I'd say this.
Yeah.
David, I would like the explanation. We'll go around the room.
Let me
start
do the
David.
Joke properly. You were an NBC page. The reason I've been standing throughout the entire show is I was a congressional page.
Yeah, it wasn't the way you said it.
Is it a filibuster joke?
I'm a queen.
You get it.
I don't get this joke at all.
And he's smarter
than
me.
There's one person listening who gets that joke.
I don't think so, David. Yeah, honestly.
Meg Ryan.
That congressman from the mid...
Mark Foley. Yeah. Mark Foley.
I think this is the one time we can say that we all agree, like in the whole world.
But
I don't think there's one...
Us,
I really don't
tweet
think there's
your
one
explanations
person.
Of okay, that joke.
If this was 12 years ago, you people would be laughing.
Right.
How does it connect to Mark Foley, though?
Well, because they were, you know, coming on to the male pages.
And
my Jew's on the cutting edge of this. Yeah. This is about to happen.
This is what I like most about the David Feldman show.
Male pages.
It's a master class in comedy, right?
Mm-hmm.
They should be paying tuition.
Yeah.
I've been writing frivolously.
All right, go ahead, please explain.
Explain the joke.
There was a male. There's a congressional page.
Stand in front
scandal.
Of class.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
That's all I remember. I'm good.
It was a gay thing.
Yeah.
So that's why I would have trouble. That's why I'd be standing because I couldn't sit because I was a congressional page.
Gays don't sit.
Because 12 years ago, I was being violated. It's a political joke. You got to understand politics.
Oh, Barney.
Political.
Barney Frank is at home just dying, doubled over.
No, I was looking at it's my fault, David.
It's sophisticated humor.
I was looking at it like it's a regular joke.
Yeah, I was
but it's a political humor. Oh, you are. Yes,
I was making a point.
Right, Barney Frank is doubled over in front of his boyfriend.
Steve Gobi was his name.
Oh.
That was the.
Gobi, like goober. I eat them. I'm going green. Get it? That's regular humor,
uh-huh.
Not political.
Okay.
All right. We're going to go around the room. What are your plans this week, David Feldman?
I don't know.
Okay.
What am I planning? To clean up.
Clean out more.
Yeah, to get my life in order.
Yeah. What's going on? What's the biggest problem with David Feldman? We'll go around the room.
I just need to do, you know... get organized. A lot of paperwork. I got a lot of jokes lying around.
Do like an hour a day and then it's not overwhelming, right?
Talk to me about that.
Okay, so an hour a day you do it and then it's not overwhelming.
Explain that to me.
Okay. What did I tell you 2 years ago about an hour a day? Go, David.
Tell me.
All right. You just take a little time. You set aside time.
He doesn't know what time is.
Oh, it's right.
That's the problem.
Okay, so you show up 10
time
minutes.
Time is that thing like.
Assume you're going to show up 10 minutes late to setting an hour aside. But just start your hour then. So, you know, so you'll still have an hour whenever you start. So then you start and then you go, all right, now I'm organizing. This joke goes in this file. This joke goes in this folder, blah, blah, blah. Right. Then another hour, I'm writing my new jokes because your head's always spinning. You know how you get. And you type those out, whatever you do. And you go, okay, that is two solid hours of work that I did. Now I can go do whatever I do. I understand you have Hulu. Good for you. You can watch some of that.
Good
I'm
advice.
Not trying to lord that over you, by the way.
It was interesting.
It was a humble brag.
Listen, unless you're planning on sharing the password with us, quiet.
I watch it without commercials. Anyway.
I need a Hulu password.
I how got you, buddy.
Tell me how to organize.
Just give me your Jew jokes. What?
Seriously, organizing one's life. Because life is overwhelming.
Get an assistant. It's not happening for you.
You do need an assistant, no joke. Get one.
Get an intern.
Yeah.
Male.
We've heard about you.
I want to know, how do you, because you guys turn out 5 shows a week.
Yeah. But that's our job, so you have to show up to your job, right? I mean, not you. You're a fucking rock star. You come when you want. But the regular plebs, we know, hey, it's time to be somewhere, you be somewhere. You know what I mean? Huh?
How do you organize? Tell me how you organize your day.
How do we organize our day, Hemda?
I think Alex is trying to get in touch with you. How do we organize our day?
That's their business. Don't worry about it.
Oh, Alex.
Hemda. Hey, who knows what they do? This is what they do. They talk to each other through a window like nobody's listening at home.
I'm being told we need to wrap it up.
Okay.
Okay.
The way we organize it is our producer tells us to wrap it up, we do it. Then we go, that time was allotted for that. So let's finish up. So it's been a great time. My name's Hemda. I'm from Keith and the Girl.
How do you guys organize?
How do we organize? We set a time to meet every day, and we meet at that time. And then we set up meeting times. We were doing once a week with my brother and Maricela, his wife, because that's who was...
they do tech stuff.
Yeah. And then we have an associate producer who's there every day. It's like a job. We go into work at least 8 hours, 5 days a week.
You need an assistant. So get one.
Wrap up the show.
Okay. So we're going to close out. We're going to go around the room and name everybody. David Feldman was with us. I'm Keith Malley from Keith and the Girl. This is Hemda from Keith and the Girl. We just celebrated 11 years. We're very excited.
Woo!
Take a look. See what's doing at keithandthegirl.com. I have 17 more jokes to tell you.
but just make sure everybody knows about Keith and the Girl. Do a serious
part. Keith and the Girl is that's honestly as serious as I can get. Go to Keith and the Girl. keithandthegirl.com. You'll see what's going on right there.
And subscribe to your podcast. It's amazing.
Yeah, we're on iTunes, SoundCloud, everywhere that you can find podcasting. If you just Google Keith and the Girl, you can find us. keithandthegirl.com. keithandthegirl.com/iTunes if you want.
There is no podcast. I was just thinking about this on the way here. I don't know why. With more shows than we have.
More episodes.
More episodes. Mm-hmm. Not one.
How many episodes do you have?
Over 2,300.
Holy shit.
Yeah. I have about 1,200.
Okay, you're catching up.
I'm catching up.
That's why we have to go to work tomorrow.
Just to keep David.
Right. It really is.
And that's why we do this.
I told Dave, I go, David, you keep us going. He goes, really? And then I don't explain it.
And just to make sure you're second best.
Right.
And your book?
Keith wrote 3. We co-wrote 2 of those together. We have What Do We Do Now? And we also have The Ultimate Podcasting Guide. And Keith wrote his autobiography, which is called The Great American Novel.
And when was that?
About 4 or 5 years ago?
Yeah, about that. Probably 6.
And how would I read your autobiography? Where would I get it?
Not only can you get it from keithandthegirl.com/store, you can also download the audio version.
At Hulu.
At Hulu Prime.
Oh, Keith,
no, that would be Audible. No, Audible. That would be Audible.
He is on Audible. Our audiobooks are on Audible. And Keith's latest 2 specials are on Hulu.com. You could just search for Keith Malley.
And now I know who has Hulu. And when I ask how was my special,
is your special
months from now, yeah, the last 2.
Wait a second. Your special's on Hulu.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And what are the 2 titles?
God Made Me, Volumes 1 and 2. I do a stand-up show every year. It's new one's coming up April 15th. And these last 2 on Hulu.
He's been doing a special every year since he turned 30. When he turned 30, I was like, fuck it. You've been doing comedy for a year. Get your shit together. We're going to do an hour. We're going to get it recorded and we're going to put it out there. And he did it on his birthday, April 15th. We got people to come out. And then we just decided to do, by we, I mean me. I was like, what are you doing with your life? We were dating at the time. I was like, let's go.
I have a joke.
April 15th.
Holding on to a joke.
So this April 15th.
I don't think it counts as holding on to a joke the whole time. So this, I'm holding on to a joke. I have a joke. I'm being polite.
Mommy, I'm being polite.
So April 15th will be the 13th one. We're going to go around the room have people stomping their feet. Let's start with David Feldman.
I have a joke. April, you were born on April 15th. Yeah. That must have been a very taxing day for your mother.
Hey,
I have a joke.
Nobody's even writing these for you. That's what's amazing about you.
I had a joke. Mommy, I made a duty.
I did that.
Mommy,
right.
You know how I send jokes to certain people?
And then you finish with, now you have to clean that up.
I'm H&R blocking him.
That's my guy.
What I write sometimes.
Dude, what the fuck?
Wait. I'm not going to be jealous of I'm H&R blocking him.
I didn't say I was good.
Hey, no. It's not buddy.
That's
it's
why
not
David
you.
Brought
it's
me here, because I'm bad.
When I send jokes to people, sometimes the headline will be, look, mommy, I made a duty.
My Jew made a joke,
I swear to God, but I
couldn't read it in the tax brackets.
Mommy, I made a duty. Are these funny? Look at my duty, mommy.
Jew, are you laughing at my last joke that I pretended you said?
Yeah. Thank you.
We have nine more minutes of tax jokes.
That's my guy.
The owner of the studio is getting pissed off at us.
All right. May I say, David Feldman?
Yes, ma'am.
You love you.
I do.
And it's always fun to be here.
I love myself, too. So it's a mutual admiration society here. Let's plug some gigs.
Yes. No gigs. Just Ange Gold on Twitter, at Ange Gold, AngeGold.
Okay. Now, he said it shy, but make sure you go, and that he gets more tweets than this gentleman, please.
Hey.
This is my Jew.
Hey,
pay attention.
This is the other Jew. At Gabriel underscore Lax on Twitter. Also
he has
gigs.
A fucking underscore. What are you doing?
Gabriel Lax was already taken.
At half underscore Jew.
That one was also taken.
Asshole.
Oh, boy. This
arrogant.
Is taking a turn for me.
God. I'm at Chemda. Good luck spelling that.
All right. And then I'm going to give you our traditional sign-off
that you have
to do as the host. But I just want to remind people to subscribe for $5 a month to our premium content.
I would like to remind people that they have spent $5 on lesser things in their life. When was the last time you went to Starbucks, dear listener? Was that a $5 coffee? $5 funds this man's life. Can you imagine?
So
why don't you adopt yourself a David Feldman for $5 on the website? What's the website?
DavidFeldmanShow.com, and do all your Amazon shopping via our site. So the sign-off is, write this in, that'll do it for us.
That'll do it for us.
From the Showbriz Studios.
From the Showbriz Studios.
In downtown Manhattan.
Mommy,
I made a duty. Can you come here and look at it? Did I do well? Do you love me, mommy? Look at my duty, mommy.
Oh, that's a really good duty. That's really nice.
Yay, mommy likes me.
I made a duty yesterday, but it wasn't as big. So I'm kind of working on it, but I'm getting bigger because I'm eating really good.
I went queen.
That's so good. I got to be like you. You're like my older brother.
The David Feldman radio program is made possible by listeners like you. You sad, pathetic humps.